We are going to discuss the third wall now, that is androecium. Androecium is the third wall and it is the male wall. Each androecium, or androecium is the name which is given to the male wall. Single member is known as a stamen. And each stamen has two parts. There is a swollen part and then there is a thread-like structure. So the swollen part is known as the anther and the thread-like part is called the filament. In case of most of the plants, we find that the anthers are bilobed. So most common is bilobed anther. And they are also known as diathecous. That means there are two lobes, one lobe and the second lobe. Whereas in certain families like Malvaceae, there is only one lobe. So it is known as monothecous or with single lobe. So we draw it like this. So it is normally drawn in the form of a semicircular structure with the filament. And here also there is a filament attached. These two lobes are connected with the help of a sterile part which is known as the connective. So when there are two lobes, they will remain connected with the help of that sterile tissue which is called the connective. Now on the basis of attachment of filament to that anther part, we are going to classify these anthers. So this is on the basis of attachment of anther and filament. Let us draw these first and then we will talk about the name or the term which can be given to it. We are talking about the diathecous one because, as we said, this is the most common type. Let us take these two first. In the first case, the filament is attached from the base part of the anther. In the second case, it is attached on the dorsal side of the anther. And in the third case, if this is the biathecous or diathecous anther and the filament runs all along the length and down. So this will be called basifixed. That means the filament is attached at the base of the anthers. This is known as dorsifixed. This one, which remains attached to the entire length of the anther, this arrangement is known as adenate. And the fourth one is actually dorsifixed, but with a slight difference. Here, the anther lobes, they become long and they can easily move when the wind blows. So these are the two anther lobes and it is dorsally attached. This is seen in case of flowers which are anemophilous. That means where the pollination is taking place by wind. So when wind blows, these two anther lobes will be able to freely move. This is known as versatile type of attachment. So there are four different ways in which the filament is attached to the anther. So this is how also we can classify. There is one more important thing that we need to talk of when we are talking of androecium or stamen. That is, are they fused or free? So we will talk of free stamen. Then that condition is known as polyandrous. The second condition is the fused stamen. Now, in fused stamen, what is fused? Is it only the filament fused, or is it the anther fused, or the third situation is where anther and filament all fused? So these fused are classified into three categories. The first one is where only filaments fused but anthers free. Such conditions are known as Adolphus conditions. Adolphus, where filaments are fused but the anthers are free. Now, depending upon how many bundles have they formed, we will classify it as monoadolphus. Monoadolphus means all the filaments have fused to form only one bundle. This is seen in case of Malvaceae family. If you are able to recall the structure of China rose, we find a staminal tube and we find there are many small structures at the tip of which there are these yellow anthers. So this tube-like structure, which is the staminal tube, is actually formed by fusion of the filaments. And the anthers, they are free here. And some part of the filament is also free. But all the filaments have fused to form only one bundle. This is seen in case of Malvaceae family. Only one bundle, so it is monoadolphus. The second type is known as diadolphus. That means there would be two bundles. And this is seen in Papilionaceae family. In Papilionaceae family, 9 filaments fuse to form one bundle and one remains free. So how do we draw it? This is one bundle and there is one which is completely free. And in case of the 9 which are fused, we find that the little part is free here. So it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. 9 have fused to form one bundle and one is separate. But there are two bundles formed and that is why it is known as diadolphus condition. The third one in case of this is the first, this is the second, and we'll try the third one here. If there are three or more than three bundles, then we will call it polyadolphus condition. Polyadolphus means more than two or more than three bundles. This is seen in case of citrus plants, also in castor. So what happens is, filaments, they fuse to form bundles and some part of the filament remains free. Here is another bundle, here is another bundle. So there are many bundles which are formed by the fusion of the filaments. And in every case, anthers are free. So when we talk of fused androecium or fused stamen, we need to identify which part is fused. In the first category, we are talking of only filaments fused. Anthers are going to be free. Such condition is known as adolphus condition. And on the basis of number of bundles formed, we'll have mono, di, and polyadolphus condition. In the second category, anthers are fused and filaments are free. Anthers fused, filaments free. Then this condition is known as syngenaceous condition. Syngenaceous condition, or there is one more word which is given to this, and that is known as synanthrous. Synanthrous, syn is for fused and anthrous is for anthers. So in this case, only anthers are fused, filaments are free. So how would that look? Suppose we are talking about this one anther and I'm drawing them with different colors so that we are able to see those anthers. This is the second anther. And say we draw one more. This is the third anther. Anthers are fused to form a ring-like structure. And their filaments are free. Then that condition is known as synanthrous or syngenaceous. And this condition is characteristic feature of Asteraceae family. That is sunflower family. So in the first case, filaments fused, anthers free. In the second conditions, anther fused, filaments are free. And in the third condition, both are fused. That means anthers and filaments are fused. So here, anthers and filament fused. This condition is known as synandrous. Synandrous. The first one was synanthrous. This is called synandrous. Syn is always for fused. Anthrous is for fused anther. Here it is syn again for fused and androus is for the androecia. So in this case, anthers as well as filaments both are fused. So these are three important fused conditions. But in this case, we have to remember which part is fused. And if it is free, then all these filaments, anthers would remain free and we'll call it polyandrous condition. Synandrous condition, that means when androecium is fused, is seen in case of Cucurbitaceae family. So these conditions are also characteristic features of different families. So it is easier to remember that way also. So attachment wise also we have classified, and the fusion wise also. Now in the next part, we'll talk about if anther is attached to some other whorl or not, and can there be different lengths of the filaments. So we'll try to classify stamen on these two criteria.